over under win totals in the NBA. Vegas projections. Clippers 55.5, Bucks 54.5. Sixers, you see. Utah should be pretty good in the West. The revamped Lakers, the Rockets we've already talked about, and the Denver Nuggets at 50.5. So these are the 50-win teams. What do we think first about the Clippers at 55.5?
It's more than possible. I mean, they won 48 games last year. You don't think that they can win seven more with the addition of Kawhi?
Cam, the question isn't whether they can get 55. Is it over or under?
Yeah, I think it's going to be over 55. I think I'm going to give them 60.
I think at least 60.
They're going to get 58 to 60 with that defense.
Yeah. Now, Lakers won 37 last year. Of course, they have AD coming. They've tweaked the roster in many other ways as well. Over, under 51.5. What do we think? That doesn't matter until the playoffs anyway, but this is just
No, it's interesting. Yeah. It is interesting. Now, how much does load management play into this with LeBron? Because he wants to be as fresh as he can for when it matters. They'll be a playoff team, right? So, and that's why I love, like, Vegas is so smart, because it's like, instead of saying 52 wins, which I would probably project would be their win total, you give the 51.5. So now you got to say over, right? I think 52 looks like their window.
Yeah.
I'm going over.
Yeah, so that'll be
over. I'll do it as well. Yeah. I'll do it as well, yeah.
Warriors have won at least 51 games in the regular season for six straight years. Yeah. Their over-under is 47.5.
I'm going under.
Well, under 47.5? Why?
Klay's not going to play for most of the year. If I'm that team, Steph Curry has played in five straight finals, a lot of wear and tear on him. I would probably try to dial back some minutes there as well and just be concerned. Look, they could still be an eighth seed if they want to, if Klay comes back and is healthy. But why not have this be sort of that reset year for everybody physically? And then you can try to make a second push. They are in the new building. They aren't going to want to be a bad team, of course.
Yeah.
But I don't see a reason why you'd want to really go pedal to the metal when you know you're going to have – Steph Curry needs to get some rest. And Klay's coming back later in the year.
And how does D'Angelo Russell fit with Steve Kerr's system?
Well, it's a lot of pressure on his shoulders because, as you mentioned, Alan, no Klay Thompson. KD's gone. You lose Iguodala. You lose Sean Livingston. Quinn Cook. That's a bulk of their guard position. So you're asking a guy in D'Angelo Russell, who had a phenomenal year last year in Brooklyn. Like, make no mistake about it. But that's a heavy task for him to come in and just jump in within a new system, a new team, a new mindset to pick up and add to what the Warriors
are. But I think he's capable of the task. You know, his first year with Kenny Atkinson, like I was saying, he was coming off the bench sometime. He had to be coached. Kenny Atkinson really coached him. He became a really good player.
But the expectations weren't there like they're going to be in Golden State, though.
Now that he's an all-star, I don't know if you watched him at the end of the season and during the playoffs, he was playing with such an amount of, like, confidence. Like, he's an all-star now. He's going to bring that same swag and that bravado out to the Warriors. That's what I feel like. I think he's really arrived. I think he learned from his younger days. Now he's the player that Coach Kerr is going to be able to put into the system and be seamless.
But you got to believe he has to reel that in a little bit. I mean, you've seen that with Golden State. They've had Nick Young, Boogie Cousins. Those
are you
guys,
comparing Nick Young to
I'm just saying, in
Andrew
terms of
Russell?
The personality.
You know what? Get up. Just face it off. We need one of these over here. Get up. Let's go.
I'm going to save it.
All right. We haven't had one. This is a face-off when guys here have different opinions.
This is funny because John and I had the first face-off.
All right.
We're going back and forth.
Let's revisit the face-off. Go ahead.
But at the same time, John, the personality. This is what I'm talking about. Not comparison in terms of the production on the court. Now, we know that Russell is a lot better than Nick Young. Boogie Cousins at one point in time was one of the best bigs in the league, but you're going into a different situation where D'Angelo isn't going to be the guy. So whatever you're doing in Brooklyn, that's not going to work in Golden State.
But like I was saying, like I stated on Monday on the show, there's like 90 to 95 shots in the NBA game. So he's going to figure out, he's going to get his shot. He's become the player that he's become because of the coaching that Kenny Atkinson has given him. Now he's a real, like, he's a pro's pro.
Yeah, after one season, now he's good.
No, two seasons.
Well, I mean, in terms of what he's accomplished this past season.
He's changed his whole game. Now he's an all-star. He went from a one-foot out of the NBA.
John, you can't tell me by getting one all-star nod is going to change everything in your
life. They thought his career was over.
Call it a push.
Then he came to Brooklyn, now he's an all-star.
That's a heavy
tackle. You think he's going to regress now?
Come on over.
I'm not going to say he's going to regress, but he has to be able to try and fit in
out there.
That's not what Golden State has, though.
I lose my chair.
What's going on, Bill? Look at this. Look at this.
Take a knee.
We're good.
All right. Can I say something, please?
Go ahead. Finish up.
It's not about fitting in. It's so easy. We can all fit in the Golden State Warriors.
I don't know.
Read and react. They're telling me that it's not about fitting into a team
that has been to the finals five
he's
straight years.
He's gonna be the second best player on that team immediately.
Yeah.
He's the second best player on the team.
Here's the only point, though. Here's the only point is that it's not that team anymore. That's the only thing. It's not that team anymore. And I actually think that D'Angelo is going to have the basketball in his hands a lot more to allow Steph to play off the ball.
Now, these guys are just picking on everybody that's under 6'4". Like, they look like the tall guys. They're really picking on us.
Damn, I wish I could school you, but I don't have enough time.
All right. The Nets.
That's supposed to be my
Nets guy. Last year with D'Angelo Russell won 42. This year they got Kyrie Irving over under 45.5.
Under.
Nets. I take under.
Yeah.
Kyrie didn't get along well in Cleveland.
You're going over?
Over.
Why do you think he's going to fit?
Where's the scoring coming from, Alan?
What about the chemistry with Kyrie Irving?
A lot of their opponents obviously are in the East.
Isn't strong. They got two of the top three teams rated in the NBA right now.
They have arguably the best point guard in the East, okay? So they have that. They upgraded that position. They upgraded a position. They have the health in LeVert, who's turned into an excellent player.
I like LeVert.
Dinwiddie, an excellent player. Jared Allen now has some backup with DeAndre, right? Jordan comes in, so there's a little more defense, but also some size so they can take on guys like Embiid and Horford and those types that they struggled against because Jared Allen's a little too thin. So they got better, and they were a 42-win team. Well, even without Kevin Durant being available to them, but they got better.
They lost Dudley and Damari Carroll, some locker room. Just
seriously?
Locker room guys.
Yeah. Yeah.
Locker room guys.
But this is
DeAndre's a locker room guy.
He is.
He was here. DJ was great in his locker room here for the short time he was part of this group. So he's a good locker room guy. And it's also that team as they've grown up. That's their locker room. This team's going to be better. And the East being what it is, they're a top four team. And if you're a top four team in the East, you're closing in on 50 wins. They'll be one of those teams.
So you're depending on Kyrie Irving and Caris LeVert to carry this team for a full season. After those two, where does the scoring come from? Jared Allen is not going to get you buckets.
Well, how did they do it last year?
Well, it was a majority. It was a group effort.
Oh, I'm sorry. I also forgot to mention the three-point champ, Joe Harrison, on this team as well. And that guy's one of the best three-point shooters in the game, over 40%.
Kyrie overshadowing developing young players like he did in Boston. That's the one thing I'd worry about.
I'm not concerned with it because one of those players is the guy who recruited him in Dinwiddie. Right. They have a relationship already, unlike what he had in Boston, where he was just thrown into the mix.
That's last up, Knicks, over under 27.5. I go over there.
Over.
Yeah, I think
over.
The Knicks have
it. I'm not a gambling man, but I'm taking all my money and I'm betting on that. I can't believe I'm definitely going over on that. I can't wait for the season to start. I can't believe they got us so low, but hey, thank you, Vegas. I'm going to make that bet.
I think they got a really good chance of making the playoffs.
I'm going mid-30s. I'll say 34
I think that's
probably a good number.
You can shoot for that for sure, like even double your win total and then even be better, all depending on. And I think Dennis Smith Jr. is such a huge part of this.
Yeah.
We kind of know what we're going to get out of Julius Randle, right? I think we can all expect if you can get the 20-8 that he did last year, that's great.
You're big.
You still need the point guard to do something. Dennis Smith is the one who already said it. We can be a playoff team. If I can take my game to the next level, let's see it.
Yeah.
Should be a deep rotation as well after the starting five, depending on who David Fizdale decides to start. It's going to be depth behind those five starters. For more great videos from the MSG 150, check out right there. And remember, our show is on Monday through Thursday, 8 to 10:30 p.m. on MSG Network and MSG Go.